combination with electronic instrumentation, we will see the next measuring instrument, that is a CRO. And these are the further types of CRO. Up till now, we have seen this AC to DC power supply, output transformer, analog ammeter and voltmeter, digital multimeter and function generator. Now we will see the CRO and then a digital studio oscilloscope and power scope. CRO is nothing but a cathode ray oscilloscope. Power scope and CRO construction is same, little difference is there in CRO and power scope. So first we will see CRO and then we will see the power scope. So main components or main parts of CRO are cathode ray tube, that is a CRT, then vertical amplifier and horizontal amplifier. Now first we will see the cathode ray tube. Now cathode ray tube is mainly constructed with the vertical deflection plates, horizontal deflection plates. This is electron gun which is going to emit the beam of electron, and phosphor screen which is coated with the luminous material like a phosphor. So whenever electron beam bombards on this phosphor screen, that particular bombarding area or bombarding spots get illuminated. So its intensity can be controlled with the help of intensity control, and its focus is also going to be controlled with the help of focus control. So this is going to give the visualization of the electron beam which is bombarded on the screens, and the deflection will depend upon the control of vertical deflection plates and horizontal deflection plates. Now this beam of electron is deflected or it is going to move up and down depending upon the input signal applied to the vertical amplifier. Now whose amplitude or frequency we want to measure, that signal is applied to this vertical amplifier, which is going to amplify that applied input signal vertically. Then it is further given to the delay line, which is going to provide certain delay before it is going to be given to the vertical deflection plates. Now this is again the same signal after the vertical amplifier is going to be applied to the horizontal amplifier through this time base generator and trigger circuit. This trigger circuit is nothing but to stabilize the electron beam on the phosphor screen, and time base generator is to adjust the time base which is used to measure the frequency. Now here vertical amplifier amplifies my signal vertically, and here horizontal amplifier amplifies my signal horizontally, and the same signal with the help of delay line is applied to this deflection of beam of electron. That means deflection of this beam of electrons is proportional to this delayed vertically amplified signal as well as this triggered horizontal amplified signal. Now if you don't apply any input to this electron beam will generate, electron gun will generate the beam of electron, and which will follow the straight path and will stop or bombard on the fluorescent electron screen. So without any application of the signal, we will get simple spot on the CRO screen. But whenever we apply the signal, this electron beam is going to fluctuate up and down depending upon the applied signal and depending upon the gain of the amplifier. Now these are the main parts of CRT. Now after that CRT, these are the various deflection circuits, which are nothing but the hardware circuits or electronic circuit along with this CRT, which is used to control the electron beam as well as vertical amplification as well as horizontal amplification. Now you see the various, now and this is the high voltage supply and low voltage supply circuit is also there, which is included in the electron circuit, this electronic circuitry. High voltage supply is required to CRT because this high voltage is around 1000 volt, which is going to be generated to deflect the electron beam, and low voltage supply is required to give supply to these amplifier circuits. Now what are the various controls or what are the various knobs on the front panel of the CRO? First we have seen this is a time base knob, which is used to adjust or which is used to calibrate the time signal, or indirectly it is related with the frequency. And now another, we have to adjust the amplitude. So amplitude will be adjusted or amplitude will be read with the help of vertical amplifier, and your frequency or time base will be read with the help of horizontal amplifier. Now here there are various controls. This is holds per division control, which is used to measure the amplitude, and this is another channel. There are multiple channel CRO. Here it is a thin channel CRO. So each channel is having its separate holds per division control, and one common control is used to adjust the frequency, that is referred as a time based control. Now, how normally every CRO is having three major controls depending upon their channel. One is a holds per division, which is nothing but amplitude control. This is nothing but times per division. Another one is a time per division, which is nothing but to control my time. And third one is the intensity and focus control to control the beam of this electrode. Now we will see how CRO is used to measure voltage measurement as well as period and frequency measurement. Now this type of waveform is going to be displayed on CRO screen. Now if you want to measure its voltage, we have to see it vertically. Now from this point to this point, we have to see which is nothing but my peak to peak voltage. So, suppose we have to measure this voltage only, so this is nothing but a peak voltage like this. From this point to this point it is peak voltage, and from this point it is a peak to peak voltage. Now we have to see this axis. Now how many divisions are there? 1, 2, 3, approximately 3.8 divisions. 1, 2, 3, 3.8 divisions vertically. Suppose we will keep volts per division now on 100 millivolt, 100 millivolt volts per division. And this time per division is 0.5 millisecond per division. That means horizontal axis control, time based control is kept on 0.5 millisecond per division, and vertical axis control, that is nothing but this control, which is kept on 100 millivolt per division. That means for per division, this is referred as 100 millivolt, and for per division horizontally, this is referred as 0.5 millisecond. This is used to calculate my time period, and this is used to calculate my amplitude. Now suppose we used to calculate the amplitude. It will first, if we see the voltage peak to peak amplitude, that is holds per division, which is kept on 100 millivolt, into 3.8, this is half of the 3.8, into this, that means peak to peak. Peak to peak is a twice of my peak voltage. So 3.8 into 2, that is nothing but 0.7 volts is my 0.7 volts is my peak to peak voltage, because here we have kept the holds per division now around 100 millivolt per division. Now if you have to measure only voltage peak, so this whole divisions we have to measure, which is nothing but 3.8 divisions into 100 millivolts. So 3.8 divisions into 100 millivolts, this is nothing but 0.38 volts. So 0.3 volts is my peak voltage, and 0.76 is my peak to peak voltage. Now we see the horizontal axis of period and frequency measurement. Now we have, what is period? Period is nothing but the time required to complete one cycle, isn't it? Suppose you will take the start of this cycle from this point, and again it will here. So this is nothing but my total time, which is referred as a T. Here it is a delay time, which is required to time required to go from zero to its maximum. So here it is referred as a time delay or delay time, but we are interested to measure in time period. Time period is nothing but period required to complete one cycle, which starts at this point and ends at this point. So this, how many divisions we have to measure here? This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 divisions on this axis, there are 10 divisions, and my nap time per division now kept is on 0.5 millisecond per division. Here it is 0.5 millisecond per division. Number of divisions are 10. So what is my time period? 0.5 milliseconds into 10. So this is nothing but 5 milliseconds. So how to calculate the frequency? Frequency is nothing but 1 upon T, 1 upon time period. So this is my time period. How to measure it? Based on time per divisions into number of divisions. And 1 upon T is my frequency. So 1 upon 5 milliseconds is my frequency. So 200 Hz is my frequency. So in this way, my CRO screen or the CRO waveforms are used to calculate voltage, that is voltage measurement, and frequency measurements. Now next we will see the power scope. Power scope is nothing but which is used to measure the power signal. Power signal is which is having higher current and high voltages. So the construction is same like my normal CRO, or block diagram is also same like my normal CRO, but whenever it is used to be constructed as a power scope, there are some additional precautions or additional controls are involved in constructing with the power scope along with the normal scope. So this is same like my CRO, but there are more safety precautions because it is going to be handled with the high voltage and high current signals. So where safety precautions are there about the insulating channel, insulating the ground, insulating the connections, or some alternator probes are there. These are nothing but the safety precautions. Channels are grounded and body ground are isolated from each other due to the high voltage signals. The channel grounds and body ground are isolated from each other. Now if you see here, this is channel 1. Now ground of the channel, that means the signal which is given to this channel input contains the main signal and ground. So ground of the channel and this CRO oscilloscope ground. Here it is the same. That means body of the oscilloscope, ground of the all other circuitry, as well as channel ground, both are same. But in power scope, this channel ground and other circuitry ground are separate. They are isolated from each other to protect this circuitry because we are going to measure very high voltage and high current signal. That's why here channel grounds and body ground are isolated or separate from each other. Next is alternator provision for high voltage measurements. Alternation. Now there must be, suppose we want to measure the voltages more than 230 volts or more than 500 volts. So there are alternator provisions. Alternator probes are used because they are going to alternate my signal before it is going to be given to the input to the channels. The alternator may be 10 times or 20 times. Suppose we want to measure 200 volts, but it is alternated with the 10 times, then on the CRO we will get the 20 volts. On the CRO we will get the only 20 volts reading. Now if you connect the alternator probe here, on the CRO screen the reading will be 10 times reduced. Suppose we have to measure 200 volts, but here if you use the alternator probe of 10 times alternator, the reading will show 20 volts, but we have to multiply by the alternation factor for the calculation of actual reading. That's why it is alternator provisions for high voltage measurements. So alternator provisions are there for high voltage measurements because to protect the CRO to take the more accurate readings. Now here again, as it is handling with the high voltage and high current, precise line triggering for stable waveform. Now we have seen here in this block there is a trigger circuit. Now here if voltages are having the low voltage and low current, there is no need of precise triggering. But whenever it is high voltage, this triggering circuit must be very precisely triggered to get the accurate measurements. Because even for 1 second, if you apply very high amount of voltage, it is going to change the various parameters of our circuit. So these are the few differences from the normal scope in power scope. Now next is a digital storage oscilloscope. This is nothing but a digital storage oscilloscope which works on digital data processing. Here now up till now we have seen the analog oscilloscope. Now here it is a digital storage oscilloscope which is going to convert my data or my signal into digital form. It is going to be stored and again it is going to be displayed on my CRT of the CRO. So main function along with the other blocks, their digital oscilloscope is again same like a normal CRO, but because of this digital data processing and conversion, it has some additional box which is going to convert my analog data into digital first, going to store it and going to then analyze it and going to display on my CRO. So this is the normal block diagram of my digital storage oscilloscope, in which here it is amplifier, normal vertical amplifier in our normal scope, but after that it is going to be digitized. This output of the vertical amplifier, it is going to be digitized, it is going to be converted into digital, then it is going to be stored into the memory and circuit. This memory or the data is going to be analyzed with the help of analyze circuitry, and that digital data is used to my waveform construction before it is going to be fed to the vertical plates. Now this same signal is going to be given to the horizontal amplifier through the trigger circuit and through time-based circuit as we have given in normal scope. But here it is a clock is a separate circuit here which is going to use to synchronize my this waveform construction from the digital data and thus the signal received from this amplifier before it is going to be fed to the horizontal amplifier. So both the signals must be synchronized with the help of this clock. That's why this clock is a different block than the normal scope here and here. This is nothing but the different blocks in digital storage oscilloscope, which is going to digitize my waveform, store it, and again that waveform is going to be constructed from the stored data, and finally it is going to be displayed on CRO. So this is nothing but a CRO DSO, digital storage oscilloscope. And normally other controls are same like our normal scope, that is force per division, times per division, intensity and focus control.
Cut.
Now this is the digital storage oscilloscope details. Now what type of questions will be asked in the examination? Either you have to explain the normal CRO oscilloscopes with the help of plot diagram, then you have to explain this, or you have to explain the various measurement, that is voltage measurements, period measurement and frequency measurement using CRO, then either construction and block diagram with power scope, then you have to draw the same diagram but mention these differences in the explanation, and last is nothing but a block diagram and explanation of digital storage oscilloscope and their difference. The question could be on the difference between normal scope or power scope and digital storage oscilloscope. So you have to differentiate between this explanation point. So that could be the questions of CRO.